All right, good afternoon. Here's another update. Not sure what, when, sometime around March. Well, I'll post them with the date, so if I, whenever the post is, that's whenever I, the date is. So we've been expecting babies, or eggs at least. Right now it's feeding time. Now they're looking at me crazy because I have an iPhone in my hand. They act differently when you put the iPhone in their face. They're very shy. So here we were, starting a couple months ago, thinking that these guys were Gravit. She's turned a little funny, so she doesn't look plump. It's one of the reds and the blues down here. Let's see if I can get the focus. Their appetite's still not big. Still, they act rabbit. If you take a look at this one down here, see those lumps? That's still telling me she's carrying the lumps. Her lovely lady lumps. She's fat and lumpy. So I'm still pretty positive this one's Gravit. The other two just got me scratching my head. I think maybe it's possible she reabsorbed them. They weren't fertile. Same with the blue down here. And my double pet albino in here. She wasn't supposed to mate this year, and I put her in with the male because they got along. They didn't fight. I was running out of space. Bit of light. I say it every video. I know. One day I'll get corrected. And then she ended up acting Gravit, kind of swollen, a little lumpy, doesn't eat, acts weird. You know, normal iguana. I know some people are like, they're not pregnant, they're Gravit. Well, I have trouble using Gravit in some forms. But I'm speaking, so pregnancy. What do you say, gravity? I don't know, you guys let me know. Thank you to my new subscribers. I'm now up to 9. Woo, woo, big holla out. 9 subscribers, big dog now. But no, thanks. These guys, these videos can be a little monotonous. Because they are just me showing you my one. Don't really know what to talk about. Diet. Real simple. 60% greens, 40% vegetables, 5-10% fruit, with a mixture of calcium powder and a all-around multivitamin. There's plenty of YouTube informational channels. This is a log. This way I can keep up with it because it will always be on YouTube as long as YouTube is around. Male iguana, his appetite has picked back up. He's not as crazy with me. I've petted him a few times. So hopefully the season is over. These guys' season is pretty much 6 months out of the year. And when they're not in season, they are Gravit. See, now here's the other female I was talking about. See, right now she's fat and lumpy. So they have an extra compartment in there. They do not like the iPhone. See that? That's driving me insane. I've not been keeping track of time, so I don't know how long it's been since I had the male in here. I just figured when they laid eggs, it'd be 3 months. Feels like an eternity. I mean, they're not eating either. I mean, they eat maybe 2 mouthfuls of food and get back up here. They do a lot of digging, and there's dirt everywhere on the lay boxes. I keep it moist. I spray it down every other day, or they'll just check it. I don't let it get too dry, just the surface will be dry.
Okay. You see any eggs in there?
Nope, no eggs yet. No, I just checked them earlier. I see now the female, blue. Oh, red. See, she's not happy. Look at that. Am I crazy or is that fat and lumpy?
And you just saw her, she ate literally just two bites of her food.
Normally, on a normal basis, I've had these for 2 years now. They come in here and gobble this up and then will bitch smack me with their tail. Excuse my French, because they want more. And that's a couple months at least, I know. So she's like, excuse me. Alright, I'll leave it alone, man. So I'm anxiously, impatiently awaiting the arrival of eggs. I have my incubator set up. You see how these little guys are doing. I haven't worked with these little guys yet. They're still growing. But I don't know if I mentioned it before. I believe I have two males and two females in here just based on growth rate. That's not always the best way to do it. And also, the eyes to snout on males is ever so slightly longer than on females. Head bobbing, I'm nervous, I want to run. Got a little food. Alright, we're out. I will start working with these guys next time or so. But here's Big Blue. Well, Little Blue, he's still little. 2 years old, I took some pictures and posted on Instagram and Facebook of him out in the sun. I was going to do that today, but it's kind of raining a little bit. Let me get that out of there so it's not so shaky. And so, he started to eat a little bit more. He'll come back and finish that up. Hey, dude, I'll mess you up. I know you will. Iguana taming is, I mean, it's not as hard and complicated. They're all a little different. Every one of these guys have a different personality. I mean, yeah, they're all swole up and look like they're about to swipe you. But on a personal level, this guy had a leg injury that he's just recovering from. I think it's this leg, slightly atrophied. I could not tell if he popped his knee out of place or his hip. I soaked him for several days in a roll, and I rolled his hip. See if that made a difference, and it did. He started moving it right away after I did that, so I can only assume somehow climbing in these cages, he got his leg hung up. And but I mean, it's wired, so it, sometimes no matter what you do, accidents happen. But he wasn't using it for a while, and I worked with him, and yes, he tore my arms up. I'm still kind of waiting for this season. The whole I'm a dark color, I'm not eating breeding season, because he matured a lot faster than I thought. He was older than I thought when I got him, but he is breedable now. So next season, hopefully we'll pair him up with a friend. Let's see if I can. If I didn't have this camera in my hands, I'd be able to pet him, but now I have the camera, I do work with him.
You see this raises up because
I think, you know, honestly, I think they kind of like it. Used to, I just thought it was defense. They just close their eyes and hope that you don't eat them. See this lump right here? There's two lumps. I palpitate it. It just feels mushy. I can't, there's no defined marble or anything in there. But the eggs are still very soft, I'm sure. So that one's okay. I can do that with her. Keeping track of time. Now the red one, not so much. This red one. This is, we'll just call her Big Red One. See if I can just get her out of the way. Right now I'm just placing my hand. Good thing about these straps right here, it blocks the tail. But I can't get to the blue one, or I'd pet her. Double hat female. She likes to pet him. I can carry this one around a little bit. Oh. Alright, never mind. Not that time, buddy. I've petted her freaking 3 times today. And today she doesn't want it. Now he, as long as he's not up there, I can pet Mr. Het Albino. Come on. Yeah, not too crazy. Not a big fan. You just gotta come in here and test your boundaries. You know, do as much as you can. Softly touches and get your hands as close. Over and over and over and over. The blue one, I haven't quite made it to him yet. I can pet him when he's eating, but once he realizes that he's being petted, he's like, oh no, not having it. So that's everybody except for my stunted, gross, this poor little guy here. Hello. He's a mess, or she's a mess. The world's smallest iguana. Honestly, it's probably an albino, a no, and I've been cheated. And this is 2 years old. I've had her, focus. And I've had her 18 months of those 2 years. I'll be cleaning this, don't worry. Not knowing. Say hello, sunshine. 2 years old, probably maybe 20 inches tail, and most of that's tail. So, Hotspot 95, UV, food every day. I'm get it. Say hello, Mr. Turtle. My iguana ponies was a bust. A complete bust. Like, utterly bust. Either rats come in here and eat it, my light's too bright. I don't know. I just want to see if I can get it to work. It works. Ta-da. Alright. So now it's just turtle tank. It's a very large biological group. So Mr. Turtle. Oh, I forgot Mr. Turtle's food inside. That's right. Sorry, buddy. Alright. I am crazy with crazy scales. Thanks for watching. See you next time.